What's up, people of the internet? I'm the Big Boat here with yet another video. In this video, we'll be testing the Intel Celeron H840, which is a CPU based on the Silvermont architecture and part of the Bechtel family of power efficient processors. It has 2 cores with no hyperthreading, of course, and it has a burst frequency of up to 2.58 GHz. The Celeron H840 has the Intel HD Graphics Bechtel Rail as the integrated graphics, which have 4 unified shaders and a burst frequency of up to 792 MHz in the Celeron's case. It's also based on the same Ivy Bridge architecture as the Intel HD 4000, weirdly enough. We're using the latest drivers for it available. We also got 4 GB of RAM in single channel mode, as well as a 500 GB hard drive for the operating system, and also which game that we'll be playing today is installed. As for operating system, we're using Windows X Lite, Redstone Revival, version 2. You can find the full description of the specs in the video description down below. It's time for a dose of nostalgia with Minecraft Java Edition. I have benchmarked Minecraft on the exact same specs before, but that was on version 1.12, which yes, it does perform really well, but it's from 2017, and since then Mojang has added even more content to Minecraft in the newer versions. So today we're gonna see if the Celeron H840 can handle the latest release 1.20. I'll be using T-Launcher to play the game, because I'm a Bulgarian pirate. You can see which version I'll be playing, Forge Optifine 1.20.1, because I use a little mod that helps me build stuff far quicker called Rotated, hopefully it doesn't affect the performance. I've allocated 1.5 GB of RAM, and I'll be using the memory duct app before launching the game. We're also setting it to clear the RAM once usage reaches 90%, and let's finally get straight to the point. Now, here's the real test. Minecraft 1.20 on the Intel Celeron H840 and Intel HD Graphics Bay Trail with shaders. Sounds ridiculous, but it's possible. After all, Celerons are the best. Most shader packs out there make the game crash with an ironic outdated graphics driver's message, but there are some that work properly. As for settings, we'll be using mostly the same fast optimized settings at 1366x768 resolution set to have in the shaders options, and 4 render and 6 sim chunks. However, there are 2 options in details that we need to turn on. These are Sky and Sun and Moon. In order to prevent a funny mess with the sky when using the shader packs, download links to the shader packs are in the video description. The first shaders that we're going to try out are Sildur's basic shaders, which are pretty basic as their own name suggests. However, they do feature grass, leaves and water waving effects, a strong anti-aliasing solution and a nice swish shade to the lighting. The second shaders in the list are Chocapic 13 version 7.1.1 Toaster Edition, which have shadows and nice bloom and other lighting effects, as well as custom clouds, which I've turned on in the shader options. The third shaders for today are Project Luma, which are really, really beautiful, especially the water, it looks insanely good. They're also the most demanding shaders we're testing in this video.